Hello, in this video we're going to follow the steps for doing an install of Foglight. You've already covered these in the previous videos about looking for the resources that are needed for a VM to run Foglight, downloading the installer, and this step is to go through running the installer, and then the follow-on video will be how to connect to your instances. So I'm presuming that you've already gone to the Quest site, gone to the download free trial. And for this particular video, we're going to install on a Windows platform so we can see the user interface. But it's the same package for a command line based or a Linux based install, just without the user interface. So let's get started. Okay, so we downloaded the installer and it's in my downloads folder. I'm going to run this now as administrator, although obviously for this particular platform you need to check that you have the right permissions to install, whether it's a local admin or whatever. Part of the process I'm going to do here is install this Foglight as a service, so you're going to need that permission to be able to do that, although you could run it at the command line if you want to. So let's go through the steps. This will just initially unpack everything. And what we're going to do today is just the most basic type of install. If you need help with any sizing, or if you can review the architecture of Foglight, there may be other things that you want to do. Just reach out and we can help you with that. This is just for a POC, most basic type of installation. So I'm going to click next, accept the terms, click next. Always what to tend to do here is if you just click custom, sorry, standard, it's just going to go through and install that for you. But if I'll do custom, we can go through some of the steps and change anything appropriately. Like for example, the folder that you're going to install that to. If it's obviously not C, then you're going to need to change that to a different location, whether you want the icons. This is the step I mentioned about whether you're going to have it as a service. I'm going to say yes. Otherwise, if you restart the server, it's not going to restart itself, or if you needed to log out, it might kill Foglight. So having that as a service is straightforward there. The service will normally just run as local system, but if you are going to use an external SQL Server instance as a repository, then it will run as a Windows account to connect into it. But otherwise, it's going to be just local system. And then click install, and then the packages are just being deployed, and I'll just pause while that runs through. Okay, so first thing, most of this is just next, next, next. This is going to be the password for the default application user, which is Foglight. So normally leave that, you can change it afterwards. The HTTPS option, again, you can change that afterwards if you want, but it's just allowing the server just to be configured so only HTTPS connections are allowed. We're going to go for a normal standalone install. High availability is available with Foglight. And here, for example, we're just going to use an embedded Postgres database. Again, this is just a very basic, simple test to install. But you do have the option of deploying to a database of your choice if it's in this list, like an external Postgres, an external SQL instance, an Oracle instance, or a MySQL instance. But I'm just going to use the default embedded one. So that will create a Postgres database in a subdirectory of the install using that port. Default passwords for the repository account. You shouldn't need to change those. The only reason you might want to change the port is if you find you've got a conflict with something else that's already installed on this particular server. So the database is spun up, the schema is created, and then we have the option here of changing some of these ports. Again, you shouldn't need to unless you have a conflict. The key ones that you're interested in is we're going to connect with a normal connection to Foglight on 8080, and if we want to use HTTPS, it will be 8443. Again, we don't really need to change these unless you take in advice about how big an environment you're going to want to monitor. So we'll just take the default at this stage. And then if we've been provided with a new license file, we can search for that here, but I'm just going to choose the default trial one, which comes with the install. Okay, that will then start the service up. And for the first step, Foglight is going to start building its own environment. So it's all the packages that were deployed are going to be built into this particular install and deployed into the database. And this is going to take a few minutes. So again, we'll pause the recording here. Please note it's quite normal when you get to the 99% mark for it to actually continue for a few minutes longer. This is basically meaning that Foglight's now running, but there are some post-installation tasks that are taking place within Foglight. So just be patient and keep waiting. Okay, and so once the installation is complete, it will attempt to launch the default browser. I would suggest putting a later browser like Chrome or Edge onto the server if you want to do this, but you can also use this particular point in time to connect on this particular URL shown here from a remote server. That'll prove that the firewall is configured correctly. If you need to push through the firewall on port 8080 or 8443 to connect to Foglight, and also allow you to remotely access this Foglight install. But if I just show you the screen behind, there's the complete installation. So I can just click done at this stage, and I'll just add this particular URL. And there we go, Foglight is now installed. So I'll just quickly log in. Foglight. So to recap, we've installed the management server, we've installed the agent framework, we've installed the Postgres embedded database. The only component we haven't installed is this performance investigator feature for Oracle or SQL, and that's covered in a different video. But in principle, here, if I want to get started, just click on plus, select the type of database I want to start monitoring, and away we go. We can go through the wizard on how to connect into that particular instance and start monitoring it. But that's the steps to install. And if you need to stop Foglight for any reason, you can go into the services, look for the Foglight service, and stop it there. Okay, thanks for listening.